Hey guys, ECRG here, back with another episode. Today I've got a viewer submitted question, and this person asks, "Hi ECRG, I'm a recent graduate of human biology and looking into graduate schools for biostatistics. I was wondering if you had any advice for me, seeing that you work in the clinical field. I was applying to CTA positions, likely clinical trials assistant positions, to get some research exposure. Do you know of any biostatisticians that followed that sort of career path? New grad, onto CTA, onto biostatistician? I understand that CTA is not analytical, so I was wondering if I'd end up being pigeonholed. Also, I'm not sure if you give free career advice, so I appreciate any assistance you can provide in the matter. Best regards." And they sign their name. So thank you so much for your question. This is really a unique question. And I really wanted to make a video on it because I'm sure there's some people out there in the blogosphere or in ECRG land that are interested in the biostatistics path and want to know how to be a biostatistician, especially in the clinical research field. Because there are other places where statisticians are used, but clinical research can be hard to break into. So I think you're onto something really big here in the question that you ask. And of course, for biostatistics, you're gonna have to go back to school. You're not gonna be able to be that without some kind of graduate degree, whether it's a master's or a PhD. So that's good that you're already thinking that way. But something really good that I think you thought about was getting some clinical research experience early before you apply. And that's awesome. So the main question you asked was, if I get a CTA position, is that going to pigeonhole me later? And the answer is absolutely not. You need to get clinical research experience somehow, some way. And it's better to do that early so that after you get your graduate degree in biostatistics, that you can then go on and market yourself as having had clinical research experience. And then you're going to combine that with your biostatistics degree. So you'd be a great fit for a job in biostatistics. Because you already have clinical research experience. You understand how clinical research works. You understand the process, etc. So that's a great fit. But an even better fit would be if you could somehow work in a biostatistics department or in the statistics department before you go back and get your graduate degree. So I would say if you can get a CTA role or whatever role you can get in clinical research, maybe even a data management role, like a clinical data analyst or something like that, entry-level role, that would be great experience for you to do, and then go and get your master's or your PhD in biostatistics, and then you'd be a great fit to come back and apply years later when you've got your biostatistics master's degree to back it up. So that would be my idea. So you're on the right track. Definitely try and get some experience early, maybe even intern for biostatistics or something along those lines before. And one of the great things you could do actually is if you could somehow get a job in the statistics department in a CRO or a pharmaceutical company or some kind of biotech company, if you can get a job there before, work there for a year, you want to go to a place that has a pathway to repay your student loans. So a lot of these companies that a lot of people don't know, but a lot of companies will offer what's called tuition reimbursement. And what that means is for a certain amount, you know, it could be anything, but it's a lot of money and you definitely want to take advantage of it if you can. Some will pay for in full your graduate degree. But especially if you work in a statistics department, they're more likely to reimburse you for that statistics degree. And that's much better than paying for it on your own, is having the company pay for it for you. So I'm not really sure if this degree is something you can do part-time or if you've got to do it full-time. But that's definitely something I would explore, is the tuition reimbursement, because there's no tuition like free tuition. So I would definitely look into that. But as far as your mindset of getting some clinical research experience before, then going and getting your degree and then coming back to the field, great mindset, great idea, behind that 100%. You will not be pigeonholed because you'll be using that experience to come back for something different, biostatistics. So great question. And I think this kind of mindset can be applied for other things in clinical research. Some of the more like niche areas, maybe like data management. I would not do this for project management. Maybe like a medical monitor, some things like that. Because I talk about all the time in clinical research how degrees don't mean anything, but there are a couple things where the degrees do. For something like a medical monitor, where you need an MD, or like a biostatistician, where you likely need at least a master's to do it. Those are the things where you need a degree. But if you just want to make a bunch of money in the pharmaceutical industry, you don't need a degree for that. All you need is a bachelor's. There's a number of ways to do it. CRA being the one that comes top of mind, because there are a lot of things working for you as a CRA, and there's a lot of things that the other jobs do not provide. For example, your phone bill's paid, your home internet's paid. When you're on the road, you're not paying anything in expenses. So a lot of perks like that. There's a few more I could mention, but that's another topic for another video. But biostatistician is a very good role. They're very important to the clinical trial process. And thank you for your question. So if anyone is interested in potentially interviewing for these roles, or have questions about how to interview, or any type of advice, you can email me eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com. We also do resume reviews. We also do interview preparation. So if you're iffy about your resume or iffy about your interview skills, email me there, eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com. We'll get you right. Don't worry about it. Take care.